Alright, welcome back. Gunmen raised Abia police station. The attackers were said to have raised the main building of the police station. Alright, the news in details. The arsonists also burnt exhibits, including motorcycles and cars, at the station, the mission land. It was gathered that the gunmen also released some suspects in detention during the attack. The situation was said to have left many residents and indigents of the area apprehensive. Efforts to get Abia police spokesman Geoffrey Ogbonna were unsuccessful. Alright, he didn't pick calls or respond to text messages. Nkporo is the hometown of Abia Deputy Governor Ude Okochukwu. Alright, and then as it is, there's been a lot of reactions, my people. Right now, it is not, no, as no easy. In fact, it is not getting funny at all in the southeastern part of the country. Right now, as we are speaking, the gunmen have just raised Abia police station. And then in the process, they have been able to release some inmates. And then that is another one. What is actually happening right now? Yes, the gunmen have not attacked. They just attacked the Abia State police station. And then, as it is, a lot of people have been that, what is actually going on? Who are the people perpetrating this evil? Why can't they? Because I don't even understand. Do you want to tell me that this set of people that are perpetrating this evil cannot be captured? At least, even if it is one. Even if it is one person, can't these people be captured? And then that is the problem. And a lot of people have said it, that the people that are perpetrating this evil, they are this, what's it called? They are not any terrorists. They are not any unknown government. These people are known. And the majority of people are saying that they are from the federal government. And that is what we are hearing right now. Yes. And then it has been gathered that they are trying to use this medium to destabilize the people of the, you know, of the world. That is the Southeast IPOB members that are doing all this. Now, nobody is too sure of who and who is actually perpetrating this evil. This is not funny at all. Bad news every day. A lot of people are like, what is happening? Do you mean the war has started? And the people are like, yes, the war has started already. And then as it is right now, in fact, the war is not, has been affecting the people of the southeast. In fact, from Imo State to Enugu, from Enugu now in Abia State, you can imagine what is going on. Well, there's been a lot of reactions though onto this one, and it is said that, well, like play, war don't start. Oh, thank God, Cameroon near me. All right, and then it is also said that God of our ancestors is leading the war, and the war we shall win. That is serious. All right, why? Who do we offend in this country? What is going on in this country? So much bad things just keep happening. I just don't know. Okay, and then now Igbo will surely ripe, we surely reap what they sow. That is what anonymous person has just said. An anonymous person has just said that Igbos will reap what they sowed. That is serious. Well, the thing is, who exactly is perpetrating this evil? That is what we are not too sure of right now. All right, and then as it is, I think the security operative needs to do the needful. They need to do the right thing, because right now nothing is being done. Nothing tangible is being done. We need to know these unknown gunmen. Yes, we don't. You can't just be concluded that they are the Eastern Security Boys, or the Eastern Security Network Boys, or they are the IPOB. No, we need to know if we actually have security in this country. What is their job? We need to know all these people. Yes, enough of all this mediocrity that you are telling us that unknown gunmen, they burnt down police station. These police people, are they not trained to capture criminals? What is their job? At least If you can't capture all of them, you should be able to catch one of them. Well, because this whole thing now is not sounding so fishy. That is to tell you that, as in to me right now, it's showing that these police people, in fact, they all know what is going on. Everybody knows who and who is perpetrating this evil. Because you can't tell me that so unknown gunmen who are not trained, you, the police force, you are trained, will now go and you will not be able to bring down one person that will now reveal the rest of the people. No. We can't take this any longer. Something is fishy in this country. And that's to tell you that most of the atrocities that is being committed, you people know what is going on. All right, and then according to what has been gathered here, say, well, if your brother or sister is in the army or police, advise him to quit now. Okay, well, civil war done, they start small. Now why? Well, we were nowhere is safe for Niger now. War everywhere. All right, and as you can hear, that's nowhere is safe. Well, it is very unfortunate that some people have not understood the game which the Hausa Fulani terrorist group is playing in the southeast. That this is what we are talking about. Yes, and then according to the statement, it says, well, this Fulani terrorist group has been the one responsible for all these attacks on the police stations and then others, and their aim, okay, and their aim is to destroy the little security network in the southeast and finally unleash a catastrophic mayhem against the innocent citizens unchallenged. And this is a well-planned game with the Nigerian government. But God will judge every one of them. Yes, I'm taking this up right now, my people. We are taking it up. Exactly what we are talking about. You can't tell me that all the atrocities that have been happening in the southeast are being committed by the Eastern Security Network, burning of their home police station. No. It can't happen. Well, it has been revealed that it is very unfortunate that some people have not understood the game which the Hausa Fulani terrorist group is playing. Well, in the game they are playing in the southeast, yes, and then according to, you said, this Fulani terrorist group have been the ones responsible for all this attack on the police stations. All right, and then others, and their aim is to destroy the little security network in the southeast and finally unleash a catastrophic mayhem against the innocent citizens unchallenged. And this is a well-planned game with the Nigerian government. Hey, Subuna, don't hear Ram. Okay, and that is exactly what is going on. This is exactly what is going on. For the federal government to have in the first place tagged IPOP and ESN, a terrorist group, my brother, something is fishy. Because they know that this set of people are the one that will go against their plans. So now they see that these people are not relenting, so they have to call them a terrorist group. Because they are affecting their plans. They are disturbing their business. And then it will not work for them. That is why a lot of people have been saying that if somebody like Shekau and his boys can be captured and then give them rehabilitation or rehabilitate them, then this set of people that are the main terrorists, if they can be rehabilitated, what as a consul did, that means consul should not be dead by now. A consul is supposed to be alive. That is it. If somebody like a consul who is fighting for only his region, so that this Fulani S-men will not enter to destroy his people, if they can capture him, call him terrorist and kill him, then why would someone like Shekau Boko Haram be given amnesty? That is what we are talking about. Hey, my brother, my sister, you people should wake up. You see these people causing this havoc. They are not this ESN and the hype up. We have seen it. The handwriting is clearly written on the wall, and we can see it. God will continue to judge them one after the other. They are not bigger than God. All right, and this is so absurd. Well, what more can we say onto this one? Meanwhile, my people, let me have more take from you on this, and remember to subscribe for more updates. Thanks and God bless.